Sabi ko nga, I want to know if yung PDAP mo, ibinigay mo doon sa Redcross, inedikit mo, so that pag nakomingle na yan sa funds, there can never be an audit in your theory. I disagree with you as a lawyer. The Constitution itself requires bidding. Yan ang sinasabi ko, Dig. Pinipicture mo na grabbuster ka, that you are an upright person, that you are decent. When as a matter of fact, meron kang 88 million na attributable to you na hindi mo binayaran.
Ayan na po mga lods, unti-unti na po lumalabas ang baho ni Senator Gordon. At saka meron din po pala siyang problema na ginawa sa Red Cross. Yung pong false positive na ginagawa po o dinideklara, dyan din po pala nagmula. Biruin nyo yun mga lods, yung mga opisyal ng gobyerno, pag swab daw po, na-test ng positive, pero nung nire-swab po, negative po pala. Mga kababalaghan sa Red Cross, kala ko po sa dugo lang po merong kababalaghan dyan. At meron din po siyang utang o hindi po binabayaran di umano ayon po kay PRRD na 88 million. Hanggang ngayon po ay hindi pa po niya binabayaran. Saan po kaya napunta? At akala po ni Senator Gordon, hindi po siya pwedeng imbestigahan dyan sa Red Cross ng COA. Yung PDAP daw po, baka daw po kala ni Senator Gordon kapag inihalo po yan sa loob ng Red Cross, hindi na daw po matutuklasan. Nagkakamali daw po si Dick Gordon mga lods, no? Yan po ang inyong tunghayan dito po sa pahayag ni PRRD. Sobrang init na po ng kanilang balitaktakan at unti-unti na po talagang nalulusaw si Senator Gordon. Yung mga paawa effect mo, Senator Gordon, hindi na po uubra yan. Doon po tayo sa totoo lang, huwag po tayong magtago sa likod ng inyong maskara. Huwag niyo po gamitin ang Senado para po sa inyong pamumulitika. Imposible po talagang walang bahid ng politika yung ginagawa niyo kay PRRD. Gusto niyo po siyang siraan para po sa inyong pambato sa susunod na eleksyon, kayo po ang manaig. Kala nyo lang po mangyayari yun. Pero bago po ang lahat mga lods, kung bago lang kayo sa aking YouTube channel, please click the subscribe button and click nyo rin yung notification bell para lagi kayo ma-update sa mga video kong ina-upload. Maraming salamat po sa lahat po ng mga nagla-like, nag-share, nagko-comment ng video kong ginagawa. Mabuhay po kayo mga solid, mga DDS at saka loyalista nating tunay dyan. Eto na po mga lods, panoorin po natin ang mainit na banat ni PRRD kay Dick Gordon.
Now, let's go to now to the Philippine Red Cross. When I asked for an audit of the Philippine Red Cross by COA, it is with legal basis. Under the Constitution and Republic Act number 172 of the Philippine Red Cross Act of 2009. Alam mo, kailangan ko ipaimbisiga ang Red Cross for a host of reasons. Pero una niyan, pera. Sabi ko nga, I want to know if yung PDAP mo, ibinigay mo doon sa Red Cross, inedikit mo, so that pag nakomingle na yan sa funds, there can never be an audit in your theory. Kasi hindi pwedeng mag-audit ang COA sa Red Cross. I disagree with you as a lawyer, and I'm pointing out to you the Constitution and the Republic Act, and I dare say that you are wrong. This is the same law that requires the PRC to submit to the Office of the President of the Philippines its annual financial report. Wala kang binigay. You know, the Constitution itself requires bidding for every centavo that goes into the private hands for the purpose of charity, yung mga itong Red Cross, a very laudable entity. Kaya lang, all these years, hinawakan mo, you squat on it and destroyed everything, including its credibility. So I ask again, where is this report? In all my years as president, I have not seen even the shadow of that law-mandated report. That is actually an omission. That is something which you failed to do. At huwag mong sabihin, wala kang responsibilidad dyan. If it is required by law and you failed to do it under malice because you wanted to hide your crimes, paano mo ginastas, paano mo sinipon yung pera sa Red Cross, then it becomes a case of anti-graft. Again, we are not attacking the Philippine Red Cross. We would just like to know if the resource says that the government has given to it is well managed. We're only asking for the same transparency from PRC Chairman Dick. Gusto mong transparency sa mga transaction? Kaya you're dwelling on a formally? Oh, in the same manner, we would like also to see if there is transparency in the Red Cross under you and you yourself in connection with the Red Cross functions, including maybe this disbursement of money. On this note, I have already instructed the Solicitor General to write to COA Chairman Michael Aguinaldo to conduct an audit on the finances of the Philippine Red Cross. Now, from ano lang na there seems to be a hesitancy. Parang nag-hesitate si, well, again, that is a mandate of the Constitution even. You failed to do that, Mr. Chairman. I'm sorry, that's of all others that you failed to do. That is a violation of the anti-graft and corrupt practices law. That is an omission. And that omission comes from the non-observance in the provision of the Constitution. But there are questions raised during the Congress hearing just today. I also would like to ask, are your testing facilities and equipment really as good as you say they are? Because I have heard of many false positive cases from your laboratories. Can you enlighten the Filipino people on this? I was informed that 44 out of 49 or 89.79% of total hospital personnel who tested positive in PRC Subic turned out negative in another molecular laboratory. Nataas ito, Dick, ha? 44 out of 49. But in another test, apat lang. 44 out of 49 or 89%. 89.7%. Moreover, in the Presidential Security Group, 187 out of 213 or 87.79 of the PSG personnel tested positive in the PRC Manila laboratory but tested negative in their confirmatory test. Even officials of the Department of Finance have experienced the same Red Cross testing facilities. Positive today, negative the following day and the day after. Alam mo kung sino ito, basahin ko, ha? I have here the list of Department of Finance workers who tested false positive. I will begin by cover letter. The Department of Finance had 13 cases of false positive PCR test results for COVID-19 from February 10 to 2021. 13 individuals were tested positive after taking PCR tests from the laboratory of the Red Cross. After testing, The individuals decided to take a second confirmatory PCR test within 24 hours. All the individuals tested negative for COVID-19 after taking the confirmatory test. Two individuals decided to take a third confirmatory test. The third test also came out negative for COVID-19. As such, we have concluded that the positive results received from the first RT-PCR swab tests in the Philippine Red Cross may be classified as false positive. The false positives in the Department of Finance may be even higher, given that not all who tested positive but were asymptomatic took a confirmatory test due to financial reasons. Yan ang masakit. We acknowledge that the PCR test may not be 100% accurate. A Harvard article, Robert Sherling, MD, states that most false positive results are thought to be due to lab contamination or other problems on how the lab has performed the test, not the limitations of the test itself. Ang mahirap nito, Dick, is paano yung mga tao na tumanggap na lang sa PCR test ninyo na positive sila when all along negative sila, but because walang pera at hindi masyado, no, di make an assertive ones, pasunod-sunod na lang, and had to endure a confinement of 2 weeks when all along tested negative pala sila. Yan ang problema mo sa Red Cross. Problema ka na, problema pa ang Red Cross sa iyo. Because of this information is accurate, then maybe the DOH must investigate this matter. You could be putting more people at risk. You could be falsely adding to the total positive cases per day of this country. Ilan yung nadagdag doon sa positive sa isang araw, daily attack, na negative, nasali na doon sa numero na pakarami na ang nasa kasakit. How sure are we now in our figures, in the veracity and truthfulness of the test combined? Kaya marami man rin nagpunta dyan sa Red Cross. How do you backtrack? If it is impossible, what do you intend to do? Ang mahirap kasi niyan, sa panahon mo sa Red Cross, may audit 86,815,433.24 is attributed to you, sabi ng COA. And in early August of this year, SBMA sent final demand for you to pay the said amount in 30 days. It has been more than 30 days, Mr. Gordon, and you have not done anything. Let me remind you that when a notice of disallowance has been issued, clearly a law has been violated. Maybe a case should be filed against you. I am now asking the concerned agencies to look into this matter. Yun na sinasabi ko, Dick. Pinipicture mo na grabbuster ka, na ganun ka, na ganun ka, that you are an upright person, that you are decent. When as a matter of fact, meron kang 88 million na attributable to you na hindi mo binayaran. And the host of other violations that I mentioned earlier, the omissions mandated by the constitutions, you know, if there is bad faith, you can be charged under anti-graft and corrupt practices.